just pulled my leg and...
ears.
Pulled your ears?
Yeah, I pulled my ears standing up. Anything interesting in this?
It's just this dude being all like heavy.
He's like, yo, what if it snowed in like Iceland? Well, after we're done here, I got shit to do, so. Wow, what the fuck? Is that supposed to be music?
This is Static X.
You want to hear after this, one tester could go and I could finish up Johnny Mosley, because I'm genuinely saying that there are like four levels you guys didn't see, so if you wanted to see them.
Oh, we need more videos of people crashing. You might as well just make this a video of you crashing.
I can do that. Sean Palmer's too good to crash. Also, they appear to have filmed all of this in one day.
Yeah.
Cadillac. Also, sudden CGI at the end for no reason.
It looks horrendous, yeah. This game plays better than Johnny Mosley, right? So this is the beginning and the end of the good game block?
Yeah.
Create a border! Actually, that looked like Crente border to me.
Any, should we deviate from?
No. Just do it,
I was looking for the hashtag.
Oh, there's no hashtag, yeah.
What if you could go back in time to, like, 2001 and tell people that we'd be dropping hashtags all over the place?
They probably ignore you.
Personal data. Sex. Male. The first real doll to ever be a snowboarding pro.
What the fuck? 13.
Is this changing anything?
No.
Oh, only people aged 13 through 30.
Can. Yeah. Someone said it to, set it to 13 and make him the world's largest 13-year-old.
Alright. Build.
Hair types. Let's make him something look just like you. Type 4, yeah. Oh, give him that pinkish red. Face. Let's see. Oh, 13-year-old. Yeah.
13-year-old?
Yeah.
I like green.
Yeah. Camo, yeah. Give me that vomit looking one. Yeah, that one.
This one?
Yeah. Whatever.
Hair. I don't care, I'm like never gonna see them. Stats, alright.
They asked us to give, well, to be fair, when I was 13, I had a beard. I just wasn't a white kid. That's my excuse.
All right.
Let's do it.
I just realized that I have no idea what his special tricks are going to be.
Shaun Palmer. Give him 10 beards.
I can't.
Digerous, I wish we could. Alright. Oh, look at that guy's face. Go back. Look at his face.
That's Shaun Palmer.
Shaun Palmer, like.
What a guy.
choices, really.
Hold on. This is... Yeah, this shows the special tricks. So I don't have any special tricks?
No special tricks.
That's gonna suck!
You suck.
That's actually going to suck.
We'll figure it out. Oh, 10 beards and back hair. I had those things when I was 13, so...
You can just pretend he has back hair.
I wish we could make him shirtless. Not because I want to see shirtless 13-year-olds, but because I want to see his back hair.
I don't think they,
I want him to be as embarrassed about his back hair as I was.
Wait, let's really get this in the 2012 mood. So as you see, Sean Palmer's a very a fun game. It really adds a lot of variety to the challenges. And so right now I'm about to go and get a very sick score using all of the tools at my disposal. Here we are starting this fun game.
Gonna play this game. Holy shit, you're so much faster. And like... slow. Fuck you. And like doing tricks that don't look like complete shit.
So as you see, I just crashed, which is one of the things you can do in this game. To break the thing, is it sad that I assumed I was gonna levitate over to that rail?
It's a little sad. How's the balance bar in this game?
It's a balance bar.
Good. Some games have really shitty balance bars, so... I do feel like you get a decent amount of air when you go off those jumps. That's kind of nice.
Yeah.
Though the game's not terribly extreme so far.
It's kind of like just what you'd expect.
Yeah. I like...
Walk it off.
Yeah, just walk it off.
Why do I ever bother spinning or anything?
Van watched these videos when they first came out. He's having PTSD flashbacks.
Yeah.
I mentioned PTSD in every one of these.
You're one of the people who subscribed to me before because of my,
because of your
Yeah.
Well. Oh. Mindless Mouth Movement started watching in when he started the X Games LP, like in early 2013. So how does it feel playing a game with good controls? Or at least controls.
It's interesting.
Is it interesting when you press buttons and it feels like that has an effect on what's going on in the game?
Yeah, I don't know what to do, man.
Yeah. Find the secret sponsor.
Like I said, some things I just remember.
Because, I mean, most of these, most of the games we've played today, it doesn't feel like whatever you do makes a difference.
Oh, and so, L2, R2.
Yeah, rights you.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
I seriously don't like not having any special tricks at all, though. Like, I would actually like to have some.
Yeah, Van was watching before I started commentating with you. I mean, we've been friends for longer than that, but...
Yeah.
Van, I hope you don't feel like I stepped into, You are you an aesthetic hipster? You hated him when he became mainstream? Yeah, I hate him. Put all your points in speed. That's what you need.
One more run on this. I'm gonna try to get the logos and try to do something else. Oh, yeah. I guess some people would have subscribed because of Omega Skydive. I don't know who, but...
Yeah. Well, I mean, that video became popular before people really got how YouTube worked.
Yeah. It was a whole bunch of sites just putting up like, whoa, look at this cool GTA video.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Oh yeah, Van says that I ruined everything. So
you did, or you?
I did. I ruined everything when I joined. Then he said, "Well, JK." So I'm assuming he means the exact opposite of ruining everything.
That
which
I ruined everything.
That yeah, it was horrible before I showed up. It was the most unbearable thing.
Probably was.
Osh 21 doesn't know what the Omega Skydive is.
Good. It's 6 minutes of me falling.
Yeah. But it has the most views of any video on YouTube ever. I like that you slowed to a stop at 147.
Did I?
Yeah, with 147 left. As though what a cunt was just sitting there thinking about his life, figuring out
what he was gonna do.
Yeah. Well, the reason Insetic was kind of tense and.
Tense
before other people started showing up. Because he didn't have anybody to talk to and explain the shit to in the games.
It was 16-minute videos of me just being reviewed.
Well, yeah, but I mean, like... Oh, that was pretty swag. You were talking to nobody, so it's harder to figure out how to narrate and stuff. Without obviously putting on an act or, you know, trying to be extra wacky.
Yeah. It was just like
which is what a lot of LPers who try to kind of be like PewDiePie. I mean, I don't think they're bad on PewDiePie, but like a lot of people do try to be like PewDiePie by, you know, they don't know what to do when they're in narrating all by themselves, so what they do is they just try to get really wacky. And you might say, oh, that's what Tinker does, tries to be really wacky. No, actually, that's how Tinker acts in real life. That's Tinker. That's the real him. He really is that irritating.
Let's move on to the next thing. I can drop back if I need more goals, but it's just like, you get one shot at some of them, and if you fuck it up, you...
Vanderpants might be the only person I know who is an Alien Ant Farm fan. Not because I hate Alien Ant Farm or anything, but I really don't know anybody who likes them. Except for Vanderpants.
The thing about this game is it loads up the same tracks first.
Oh.
So, I'm gonna put Shuffle on. The game seemed dead set on selling us Spine Shank, Static X, and Alien Ant Farm albums.
Vanderpants says, my brother and I used to listen to their CDs and play Doom 2. Sounds like he's getting into some,
He's getting into some deep
shit.
Shit,
yeah, he's, you know... That's some pretty deep shit, Vector!
Oh, wow, Vector, that's some pretty deep shit!
Yeah. That's Charmy B talking about, when Sonic the Hedgehog goes insane and, Shadow, who has been transformed into a girl, is pregnant with his child. In case you couldn't figure that out, that's from some fan fiction.
Do I really not have any special... Oh, I do.
They just don't want to tell you.
Okay. I wanted some special tricks because... Oh, wait. Can you hold that one? Oh, it's a Statue of Liberty. But it's like if you get a special trick you can hold, that can give you a lot of points.
Border score.
I think I mentioned this in the videos, but like as a kid, I could not figure out how to do these. I thought you had to like on the D-pad try to do like left, down, down, yeah. right.
But really what they mean is rotate.
Because, like, all of these are just, like, presses.
Up left.
Yeah.
Up right.
So as a kid, I think I mainly did, maybe did one special trick the entire time I played this game.
I can see how that would be confusing. And I would probably have, if I were making the game, I probably would have, a new symbol in there to show, like, rotates. Because they obviously don't expect you to do that, like, with two arrows. Although, you might be able to. So, the very bottom is like a car. Well, like at the very bottom of the hill, there was like a goddamn car.
Yeah. You can go back up the level by finding
the vehicles that are like that.
Yeah.
Nice. I thought that was the onion logo.
I'm mainly getting the score things now, I guess.
See, what I think is missing from this game, is at least from these first two levels, has been, like, really epic bonks. It has all the proper mechanics.
I don't know, that bonk thing.
That was a pretty good line. But, I mean, it's a really short line, too. Like,
yeah.
Like, this thing, most of the really good ones have had really long, epic lines. And
that
is
just looks weird.
Yeah, that's a 13-year-old if I've ever seen.
That's
one.
The face of our boy.
That's our son.
I'm trying to like remember the goals and do them quickly.
Yeah.
I don't want to get bogged down in, like, too many where it'll take the entire... What?
What the fuck was that?
I don't know. Are you fucking...
Are you supposed to do something here?
Yeah, I'm supposed to land on top of that thing.
Oh.
And I just keep
gliding. Gliding right through it.
No, I just keep jumping over it.
Not sure what they're talking about, but Mindless Mouth Movement was mentioning that there's always one stat that nobody cares about.
Yeah.
No matter what the game is.
I think it was the landing stat.
Yeah. Isn't that the same logo you picked up last time?
Yes.
So instead of picking up all four of them, you just have to pick up four.
No, you have to pick up all four. I restarted.
Yeah, but you only... That was the first one you picked up.
In a different run through.
Oh, I see.
This is one of the things where everything resets.
Because I didn't see you pick up the first one, so I thought it was like you grabbed the same one twice and it counted for two out of four. That would have been really weird. Oh, so they start you off close to another vehicle. So you can go higher up if you need.
Some of the levels have reset points that take you all the way back up to the top. Some of them have reset points that take you about halfway up. And then there would be one that takes you the full way up.
It'd be kind of cool if, like, you know how some games have courses that change slightly depending on your action game?
Yeah.
So, like, it'd be kind of cool if sliding up stairs.
Where's the fourth one?
If you could... If you could, affect the level, change something higher up, and then take a vehicle back up the course. And things are different. Like, if you cause an avalanche lower on the course, and it moved a bunch of snow down, then the upper part of the course is different, and the jumps get different, or something like that. Jesus. You murdered that person. Again.
Guys, I'm gonna admit we might have a problem, since I don't really remember where anything is.
Mindless Mountain Movement asks, didn't this game get like a 3 from IGN? That wouldn't surprise me. This game doesn't seem that bad.
Yeah. Time. I've started restarting now because I want to get 2 challenges done in the same run.
Got a 3.
I mean, it is kind of one of the more shameful imitators of the format. Like, other games tried to vary it up a little more.
Mostly talking about how dull it is. I don't think dullness is something that I would drag a game down to a 3.0 for me. I mean, like, you said the graphics are good enough, but the gameplay is dull and uninteresting. And they say, like, you know, SSX Tricky is right there on the shelves next to it.
Yeah.
So you should just pick up SSX Tricky because that's going to be a lot more fun. And I agree, it might be a lot more fun, but just because it's more fun doesn't make this game a 3, you know?
Yeah.
Let's see, anything else interesting?
I'm gonna at least get the secret sponsor thing because it's so easy. I just forgot what I needed to do.
Also, this person's saying this game is slow. And I gotta say, he didn't play Johnny Mosley.
No one played Johnny Mosley.
Yeah, but this particular reviewer didn't play Johnny Mosley, or he would know that this game is fast as fuck.
Actually, I saw the first sponsor, so I'll go for the sponsors thing as well.
Yeah, Mindless Mouth Movement said, I've only played the demo, but from what I could tell, it would be a 7 for decent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I kind of gave it, a 7 or a 6.
I'd say, like, maybe a 6, because
thus beginning my long-running tradition of never giving anything below a 4.
Yeah.
Except for the real...
Except for the
complete shit things.
Like Disney Skate,
which was so bad.
It was like a fucking one.
Yeah. Ooh, Companion Cube sadly played the Johnny Mosley himself.
Yeah.
because of or in spite of us.
I don't think this guy even knew about the vehicles thing, because he said, in Shaun Palmer, gravity intrudes here. Miss a goal once, and you have to restart the level.
Yeah, I don't think he understood the vehicles. I mean, in the early game, there's some goals where you only get like one or two shots at it. But that's because going back up the level like three times isn't feasible.
Also, this guy doesn't seem to understand how snowboarding works, because he thinks that manuals don't exist in real life. Like, on snowboards.
Uh-huh.
You don't have a problem with that in SSX, but you do have a problem with it in this game.
Admittedly, when this game had come out, SSX didn't have manuals.
Oh, it didn't?
No.
Still, manualing is a thing.
Ooh, Johnny Mosley was your childhood game? Like, your parents could only buy one game a year, and they picked a Johnny Mosley.
Jesus. How the... Oh. This guy's faulting it for having a tricking system like Tony Hawk. This guy's just a sack of dicks. Performing tricks is a more satisfying experience, but the trouble is, you can't shake that haunting reminder of Tony Hawk.
Okay.
I don't know, like, if I'm playing... I'm trying to think of a game that feels like another game, and isn't a sequel or anything. Like, if I was playing 50 Cent Blood on the Sand, right? And they were like, you know, you get this haunting feeling that the controls feel a lot like Gears of War. I don't know if you enjoyed Gears of War. I wouldn't fault the game for that. I would go, yeah, that feels right. Feels good. Let's see what's next. Question to realism aside. He thinks that the level ups, the level goals are really hard.
What?
And he also thinks that the lines in this game are just way too obvious.
I mean, that is a valid complaint, because since you're going downhill, it's like, where is this rail going to lead you? Oh, into that rail.
Sure, but my complaint was that their lines weren't long enough. It didn't seem like the lines were really going anywhere. Whoa. Physics. Anything else of interest that this guy says?
Can't spell ignorant without idea.
Oh, this guy really likes the push game mode.
Figures.
Mentioned Dark Summit in this.
Did he like Dark Summit?
I don't know, but he's talking about the animation. He said the textures are sharp and the animation is smooth, especially for the special tricks. There's none of Dark Summit's weird float or jarring snap to the movements, which makes me worried about Dark Summit.
I didn't buy Dark Summit thinking it was going to be good.
That's true.
God, I really need to get back in this fucking game. I'm not doing very well. I don't remember the spins being this snappy.
There's good clothing animation for all that baggy cold weather gear too, although not quite as nice as what we've seen in Konami's ESPN Sim Snowboarders.
Sims Snowboarders?
No. Sim snowboarders being like simulation snowboarders. Not capitalized.
No. They have to be talking about Winter X Games then.
Yeah, they do.
That game was dick.
That game was complete dick.
I couldn't pass a single event.
Well, he's talking about the animations in that game.
The animations, which looked like dick too.
Disney Skate got a 7.8. Someone pointed out that you can't spell ignorant without IGN, and Didris adds, and you can't spell that without ant either. Didris, always the voice of reason. We love you, man. Seriously, bro. Sign with this.
If you don't sign this tips, he's gonna be so mad.
I'll still be so G darn peed.
Oh, god damn it. I'm so out of the loop. I mean, I guess the game takes a while to get used to, which a game shouldn't if you play stuff like it, but.
This guy's also not a fan of any of the music in the game. He calls it generic modern heavy metal. Didris loves us too.
You may need to put in cheat codes. I don't think I'm progressing well.
There are no good cheat codes.
Any, like, level?
Oh, yeah, those. But I mean, like, there are no good ones. No,
but I genuinely mean, like, unlock all levels. Because I'm not going through this very well.
Shaun Palmer has a strong graphics engine and solid control, but if IGN gave out a fun factor score, this sucker would get a big fat goose egg. Zero. I challenge anyone to have a good time with this game, especially considering how much fun you could be having with its competition in the snowboarding market. You're not supposed to review games by comparing them to other games. You're supposed to review the game. If I wanted you to review SSX, then I would ask you to review SSX. I wouldn't ask you to review this game. It was a pretty good idea for them to alternate the color on those buttons. Otherwise, I wouldn't have seen the gap.
I don't know why there is a gap there.
Whoa. And how could he possibly say that ESPN had anything better than this game? Like, literally nothing was better in that game.
Apparently I played the bad version of Winter X Games and there's a better version, but...
What? For, like, another console?
No, there's like 2000 and then 2002 or something.
And well, it doesn't fucking matter whether or not there's a good version and a bad version. They released a bad version.
Yeah, they released a shit game.
They shouldn't be releasing a shit game. They should just give up. OSOSH21 keeps asking us to stream America's Army 2.5. I don't think I've ever played America's Army. It's probably complete dicks. Not our actual army.
I'm not able to do very much in this game. If you guys want to see the later levels, we'll have to do
it. Mindless Mouth never wants something else. He wants Winter X Games.
I think Winter X Games might have been the one game I
could do that. No, I'm pretty sure we still have it. You want me to go look? Winter X Games is so bad.
You know what? Fine, go get it. It's Bad Games Day again.
It is Bad Games Day. Bad Games Day
is back on. You hear that, guys? Bad Games Day is back on. We're gonna move over to Winter X Games. Sorry for that poor performance in Shaun Palmer, but it does. You do have to kind of get in the zone for things to work.